Hi all. In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about a program that has been getting some buzz called Dr. Cleaner. It basically cleans your disk, optimizes your memory, clears your cache, and also saves storage space, but it also supposedly tunes your system for your Mac as well. What I like about this program is you can actually see what it's doing and have that choice to either do it or not before you actually run it. So it's in the App Store again. It's called Dr. Cleaner, and let's open it up and check it out. So there it goes. It's basically telling me that I have used space of 157.27 gigs, and free space I have 31.01 gigs. So I'm going to hit the scan button here and see what it does. And there it goes. It's scanning my whole hard drive, and it says that I have about 500 megabytes in my hard drive. So I could check that and say, are you sure you want to permanently delete the trash can? I'm going to say yes. There it goes. Now it's telling me I can have 2.43 gigabytes available. That's a lot of gigs. Any in my downloads folder, if I want to delete anything that's there, I could turn that on. But actually, it's not that much. It's only 13 megabytes, so I think I'll leave that on. It's also going to take care of my mail caches and my application logs and my application caches. iTunes downloads has zero, so it doesn't have a checkbox for that. So I'm going to go ahead and clean it. And there it goes. It's running. And it's already cleaned about 30%, as you can see. So let's see how long it takes. There it goes. Actually, it's pretty fast. Boom. It has freed up for me 2.43 gigabytes of memory. And I can tell you it actually did it because I tried it out before and it did work on some other computers. This is a great way of retrieving some space back that you might have lost. And let's click finish. And there it goes. And as you can see, my free space has gone up by 2 gigabytes right over here, a little over that. So it actually did work. So I recommend this. It seems to work pretty seamlessly and it doesn't really cause any problems. I have been doing it in Yosemite and it seems to be working fine. So try it out. It's free. It doesn't cost anything. And it's a great app. Thanks for listening.